Right, I've got Jay Harris with me. I'm going to grab him whilst he's just getting the old wraps cut off there. But congratulations, mate. You're the new British champion. And it was a hell of a fight there. Just tell us your initial reaction.
It was a mental fight. Fair credit where it's due. Like Tommy fought a brilliant fight. He obviously had a game plan. From the start, really, to stick it on me. When we were even in the touching gloves, Dennis Hobson was just like, not Dennis Hobson. What's his trainer's name?
Glenn
was like, go to the body. So obviously they had. If you cut that off, mate, it'll come off straight away. And so that was their plan to go, but after the first round, I just knew he wouldn't be able to put me away. But obviously, I took a bit too many shots that I should have. Gone a bit of a walk as usual, as my normal state. But I think my experience showed in the end, and he blew himself out. And I caught him with some good shots at the end.
Getting the wraps off.
Yeah.
I've got to say, Jay, that the pace was ferocious. I mean, I really didn't expected the pace to go that long, and you guys put an absolute shift in there.
Well, obviously it was going to be like that because I wanted to win the belt, obviously, and Tommy didn't want to lose it. So both of us were giving everything.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what we did.
You absolutely did, yeah.
The fans who come out to watch and on TV, they must have had an hell of a show.
Well, I think we all did it ringside, mate. I mean, seriously, it was an absolute tear-up, but it was quality technical tear-up as well.
Yeah,
it was
brilliant,
you know.
I was catching a lot of the shots. Obviously, he was getting through with a lot as well. My face is... obviously, this was a bit of a clash of edge, but we were fighting the side, so it was understandable. I wasn't going to complain or anything like that. But yeah, he fought a great fight. To be fair,
When you share those tough rounds with each other, I mean, you must have a lot of it's a sort of experience you can't really have with many people, isn't it?
Absolutely, and look, and he's a lovely fella as well. Congratulations,
thank you
very much.
Such a class there.
He's a lovely fella.
Yeah.
We've been in touch for most of this camp, to be fair, because none of us knew what was happening.
Yeah.
And there's been no animosity,
yeah.
Nothing,
yeah.
No bad blood, the way boxing should be, I think. I think boxing is an art of a sport without all the beef and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And we put on a show for everyone.
Absolutely. You came here, the way fighter, come from Wales, and you go home with the British
belt.
Title. Yeah, it's a lovely belt. You
take
deserve
it. Take it home to my daughters, do.
Yeah, yeah.
And my missus, like I said, I was going to do. My daughter, before I come, she was like, win, daddy, win. And it's just an unbelievable feeling, like, and I'm taking it back to her.
Brilliant, mate. Well, listen.
To act to both my daughters. I think they're more excited to have a Chinese tomorrow, to be honest. But
well, you've earned the celebration, that's for sure. I mean, you guys put on a show.
They've grueled for the last 3 months, to be fair, for my family. Like, there are sacrifices. This makes it all worth it now. Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely, mate.
Absolutely. Great.
Well, I won't ask you what's next yet because you've only just come out of the ring, but we will catch up soon and find out what's next. But, Jay, for tonight, mate, congratulations.
Thank you very much, mate. Thank you.
Blessed Lord must have had an answer for me for something else because I shouldn't be here. I found my own way from zero. I've got about 12 to 15 bags of horseshit in the back of this van. And it's like that. There was violence, plenty of money. And you had to deal with things properly. About 4 or 5 assassination attempts. I'm going to do this to you. I'm going to do that to him, really. Put my foot up the front door, be in the house in his living room. I said, I'm coming every day of the week. I'm coming back. You're getting a fucking hiding. My father said, you're either going to end up dead or doing a lifetime in it. I've had guns go off at close range. I've had all kinds of things. He had me down and was running and controlling an army. Put me near a sex offender. I said, I'll kill him straight out. You play ball with us. Keep the peace in the prison. We'll have an easy life and you have an easy life. I said, give that money back, because I'll break your arms and legs. He said, you're a fighter, aren't you? I said, do fucking right, Adam, yeah. He said, well, fight back then. It wasn't for my wife and kids. I said, I'd get a bullet. I said, I'll put it right between your 2 eyes. But I've been betrayed many times. I don't leave my people behind. I take them with me. He's dying. When I say dying, he's about to have his head blown off. He's one very lucky man that I drove past there. Good comes over evil 7 days a week. I've got unfinished business in boxing. Keep going.